What up, Long Beach? Welcome back to your home for everything local sports. It's JJ.
And Mike.
And Tyler. And this 562 Classic video is brought to you by Naples Rib Company. Currently back open, so please support the people who support us.
We are taking another 562 Classic look back. This video originally produced for Gazette Sports. This recall for the Classic brought to you as part of our partnership with the Long Beach Post.
May 27, 2011, Lakewood baseball had only lost four games in the regular season, and they're hosting number five in the nation, Edison, the number one seeded team in the CIF Southern Section that year. Shane Watson going for the Lancers, Henry Owens going for the Chargers, both future Major League Baseball draft picks.
A significant portion of this highlight video borrowed by MLB TV for the draft show over the next couple years. Yes, it was the campus field feels with a packed house. This is what hometown Lakewood baseball is all about, down to the Classic fire engine.
Unsurprising that we've got a pitcher's duel early as Owens strikes out the heart of the Lakewood order, Torres, Alafatuli, and Worrell. He was a 36th pick that year in the draft. He debuted for the Red Sox in 2015, and he was still in the minors in 2018.
And some of these camera angles you're seeing are me shoved in with all these crowds. That's in the third inning. Jimmy Gassano going to lead things off with a single. And then Danny Calleca, sack bunt, moving him over. That's just more league baseball, baby.
Especially at Lakewood High School, you know, for decades. J.P. Yaco with the RBI double. Not the only J.P. in this game playing for Lakewood. Just a classic game all the way around with so many guys that we would really enjoy covering. Over the years, Jonathan Pacias, the sophomore, with an RBI double to left field. That puts the Lancers up 2-0 in the third. And then look at the tag by Watson in the top of the sixth inning.
But in that same inning, a two-out walk puts two ons. And then Jake Lozinski, I just love that name. Jake Lozinski for the Chargers, RBI single. They've got runners on the corners, and they score a run off of Watson. So he's in trouble. He was in trouble a lot, but he always seemed to get that influential pop-up to get out of the jam.
Yeah, he knew how to get himself out of trouble for sure. And obviously Watson, such a talented pitcher. Bottom of the sixth, feeling very old school as Jimmy Goh puts the squeeze bunt down to score Nick Torres and give Lakewood a 3-1 lead.
And then we go to the dramatic top of the seventh, Edison with a leadoff single. And then this fielder's choice to J.P. Crawford at short, to Jimmy Goh at second. It's a close call. And I got to be honest, Edison manager Steve Lambright had a point. But we very rarely get the replay that confirms the call on the field so conclusively.
Sometimes you just got it, you know what I'm saying? I'm over here tucked up against the dugout behind some fans, but sometimes you get the clip, and that pretty clearly shows the out was recorded and the right call was made, but things only got weirder from there.
One on, one out walk. Spud comes out to talk to Shane Watson and be like, "Do you got this, my guy?" Only the third strikeout of the day for Watson. He was inducing a lot more pop-outs than he was fanning guys. And then it's the classic Lakewood hidden ball trick. Watson fakes the throw into center field. Tyler Leadholt in center field very, very convincingly faked that there was a ball on the ground that he was going for. That would have been the final out of the game. Edison doesn't go for it, and Lambright is furious, comes out, says he saw a fake ball on the field. I believe the allegation was that some tape was rolled up and dropped on the field, and he's literally telling the ump, "Go check that kid's pockets." And I believe the ump's response was, "You've got to relax, my guy."
I mean, what is the punishment here? I don't think we've ever seen a situation like this where the umpires would be put in a situation where they're going to have to, what, eject a player and a manager? I mean, obviously the minimum penalty was what happened. They just played ball. But there's a lot between the minimum penalty and the maximum penalty there.
Well, sure. And let's be clear. I mean, this has worked for Lakewood in the past. The hidden ball trick has been successful. The audacity to try it for the final out of the game for a playoff win against the number one seed. I mean, that takes some chutzpah. And, you know, credit to Edison for not falling for it. But then, yeah, after this whole argument plays out, you eventually have to get back to baseball.
But hey, there's no penalty at all because they didn't do anything wrong. A little bit of gamesmanship, it didn't work, play on, and, you know, no harm, no foul, but there is a ground ball, and that's going to end the game regardless of what Edison wanted to happen on that call. Absolutely one of the biggest playoff upsets we've seen as Lakewood knocks off what was supposed to be a juggernaut Edison team 3-1, and you can see how emotional and excited they were. One of the best baseball games we have ever covered, regardless of time of year. Matty Nuez listening to the protest and then saying, "I don't know what you want to do with me, but, you know, call God, but we won the game and we're going to go celebrate."
Lakewood football team celebrating with them. We've got to mention that I was not at this game. This game was covered by Mike and Tyler, And I was at the Wilson game that they also won. So Wilson and Lakewood went on to the semifinals that was hosted at Blair Field that next week, but they weren't able to pitch Shane Watson and Chase DeYoung because they had both pitched these quarterfinal victories. Well, Lancers and Bruins both lose those semifinals at Blair Field, and we've got the stats to back it up. That really started the More League Baseball playoff curse. This was the last time that we covered two Long Beach baseball teams playing in a CIF quarterfinal on the same day.
And we also got to mention Shane Watson, the 40th overall selection in the 2012 draft, going to the Phillies, and had a five-year career in the minor leagues.
You know, we've remained close to a lot of these guys. I mean, we still see a lot of them around. A lot of them played baseball for a long time. J.P. Crawford is going to be playing with the Mariners this year, as a matter of fact. But also, you know, one of the guys we mentioned, Tyler Leadholt, passed away really tragically a few years ago. And I think when we're out covering these games, to us, it's just, okay, this is what I got to do on Wednesday. I got to go to this game and get this video. But, you know, I know that this video was shown as part of Tyler's memorial services. And this is like a really treasured moment for all the guys on this team. And it's interesting for me taking these looks back, because we don't think of these games as having that kind of significance because we're older, right? We're not 17. It's not the most important thing in the world to us. And I'm just really glad that we were able to be there and get this memory so that those kids can always wind it back and watch it anytime they want to.
What memory do you want to look back on? Let us know what video you want us to do for our next 562 Classic as part of our partnership with the Long Beach Post.